Hello there, my beauties. This is Linda and welcome back to my channel Makeup Maniac by Linda. Today's video is a very gorgeous traditional Asian bridal makeup look. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to create this beautiful, gorgeous makeup look on yourself on your special day. This wedding makeup is inspired by the Indian brides, Bangladeshi and also Pakistani brides. And this look would be perfect for the wedding day, what we call nikah, or even your akd day. Our Asian brides have a signature way of wearing jewelry, which I have tried on today. I have created the eye look in such a way so that this look can be paired up with almost many color varieties of dresses. So this will be suitable even if you're wearing a sari or even a lehenga. And you can alter the lip color, of course, depending on your preference and how bright you want your look to be. However, if you are someone who don't like jewelry that much and if you want to go simple and yet glam, then you can just avoid the jewelry and follow the makeup look. But today I wanted to dress up like an actual bride and so I did. Also get your hairstyle depending on what kind of attire that you're wearing. So for the sake of not making this video very long, I have done my base makeup earlier. All the makeup details you have to check the description box down below and make sure you subscribe to my channel if you aren't yet. So without any further ado, let's jump into the main video. To start off, I'm using my MAC paint pot in the shade Soft Ochre and using my Sigma E58 brush, I'm applying that onto my eyelids. Now to mattify that, I'm using my W7 Banana Dreams and using my Morphe E30 brush. Today I'm going to be using the Juvia's Place Saharan palette and from there I'm taking this light brown shadow as my transition shade. And using my Morphe MB23 brush, I'm applying that onto my transition area. Take little product at once and just blend it as you go. Now using this orange warm toned shade, I'm using that on top of the transition color and intensifying that a little bit to get some warmth onto my eyes. Now from the Sleek Garden of Eden palette, taking this dark brown shadow and using my Morphe M506 brush, I'm applying that onto my outer corners and onto my crease to darken it a little bit. Again, using the same brush and that orange shadow from the palette, I'm going to blend the brown shade so that there is no harsh line. Taking this black shadow from the palette, I'm applying that onto my outer corners to darken that even more. Now using this copper shade from the palette and Morphe 124 brush, I'm using that to apply onto my lid and I'm just applying on the middle part of my lid. And now for the inner corners, I'm going in with this light bronze shade using my Anastasia Glow Kit palette and this Sigma Smudge brush, I'm using this shade to highlight my brow bone. To line my eyes, I'm using my Flormar gel liner. Using my Maybelline Colossal Kajal, I'm tight lining my eyes. And for my mascara, I'm using my recent favorite Flormar Triple Action Mascara. This is a 3-in-1 mascara, as you can see that the wand can be rotated into 3 different styles and I have showed you here. Get all 3 effects of volume, curl and length from the same mascara. Now applying that both onto my upper and lower lashes and after that I'm going to use my pair of false lashes, which is from Jans. Using the brown shadow from the Sleek palette, I'm going to smudge my lower lash line. And now again using the Anastasia palette, I'm going to highlight my inner corners. For my brows, I have used this Benefit Brows Inks and I have already done my brows off camera. To keep the brows in place, I'm using this Ardell Sculpting Gel. Today I have used this Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation in the shade 2W2 Rotten. And now to mattify the foundation, I'm using my Chanel Face Powder in the shade 20 Soft Beige. I'm using my Sigma F80 Flat Kabuki brush to apply that and slowly I'm pressing the face powder onto the foundation so that the entire face is covered and it looks matte. Also don't forget to apply foundation and face powder to your neck so that it looks matched. Now to bring back some definition and shape onto my face, I'm using this Too Faced Cocoa Contour Palette and I'm using my Morphe 178 brush. I'm just creating a funny fish face and then I'm applying the contour powder onto the hollows of my cheek on both sides and then I'm also going to contour my jawline. This will make my face more sharper. To clean up the edges of the contour and make it more defined, I'm using this W7 banana powder to bake my face under the contour and then also applying that under my eyes so that it's more long lasting and it doesn't crease. Now using the same powder and Sigma E40 brush, I'm contouring my nose. Wait for a while for your powder to set, and then just using a big powder brush, just dust it off. Now for my blush, I'm using this Kryolan blush palette. From there, I'm mixing this coral and pink blush to get the perfect shade that I want. This palette is my recent purchase and I'm loving this. Now using my Anastasia Glow Kit and my Real Techniques setting brush, I'm applying the shade Sunburst to highlight my cheekbones. This palette is a must have for highlighter lovers. And then I'm going to highlight my tip of the nose and also the bridge of the nose. And then also applying a little bit on my Cupid's bow and then also on my forehead. To line my lips, I'm using this Jaclyn Brown lip liner, which is a very inexpensive but very good lip liner. And then I'm gonna use my Kat Von D lipstick in the shade Plath or Plath, whatever it is. Now to make sure that my makeup lasts all day long without budging or smudging, I'm just gonna apply my Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray onto my whole face. With that, our makeup is complete and here is the final look. I hope you all liked this look and I just loved how this turned out with all my jewelry on and also having my dupatta on head. This looks very gorgeous and very traditional. Wedding is a very special day in any girl's life and all that I want to say is all the best to all of you who are going to be brides soon. And if this video helped you in any way, then I would be really glad to know that. Even if you are a guest of a wedding, or even if it's your sister's or anyone else's wedding that you're going as a guest, you can try out this look. And wedding season is almost there, so brace yourselves up for all the invitations and rock yourself. I have also included some shots where I do not have the ghungat or dupatta just to show you that this makeup will also look good on you even if you're a guest at a party. And I just did a very simple eye which any of you can do easily. For all the product details, make sure to check the description box. And if you enjoyed this video, then please give this video a thumbs up. And make sure you're subscribed to my channel and also share this video with your friends who you want to get married soon. This is Linda signing off for the day. Bye bye and take care.